Previously on the unit.
I sent you to 200 hours of community service. You are dismissed. Trying to find someone who will be understanding and flexible as to how I serve that time.
Wilson, I wanted to see...
What does this guy have to do with anything?
I don't know. I had to...
You had to what?
Christine, can you go see how they're doing up front?
Wilson.
I need to talk to Tiffy.
Take a look at it. Wall, you wanted to see it. All right, here you go. 1, 2.
Hey, what's the crash code for today in Washington?
Butterfly.
Man has to walk away and can't come back.
How's it paid for?
A unit member has to disappear.
It's funded through taxes.
Once in, never out. Diamonds were delivered on schedule.
I'm not asking about the schedule. I'm asking about the diamonds.
My team made the delivery.
Of what amount?
When we made our delivery, they were all accounted for.
$4 million worth of CIA property vanished.
I regret your loss.
According to our intel...
Your intel is wrong and your informants are liars. If you had anything conclusive, you would have issued indictments by now.
Is that your version of you can't prove anything?
There's nothing to prove.
You have a theory as to how $4 million worth of diamonds might have gone missing?
You want a theory? For all I know, CIA took the diamonds. Now you've come to my team looking for someone to hang it on.
Do you know the penalty for treason?
I tell you what. When you prove I'm lying, you can tell me the penalty then.
Just give me a minute and I'll get out of your way. I missed breakfast. You hungry?
Thanks, I'm fine.
It's a good omelet.
Mm-hmm.
In 1783, Napoleon bet Marie Luigia that he could make a perfect omelet. The secret, he explained, was to flip the omelet in the air and catch it in a frying pan. When Napoleon flipped the omelet, it fell to the ground.
Is that so?
Well, yes, it is. And legend has it this was Napoleon's first defeat.
Well, you can't beat history.
No, but you can shape the future. And the signs of potential defeat are there for someone who knows how to recognize them.
You're my interrogator.
Technically, that's correct.
And you're CIA?
Yes. Oh, but this isn't an interrogation.
No man on my team can tell you anything different from this. If you had anything conclusive, you would have issued indictments by now.
We'll shake your entire team until we get the answers.
That's an interrogation. We spoke to the courier in Milan.
The courier in Milan?
Yes, your mate gave him a concussion, and he involuntarily turned over more than $14 million in diamonds to your team.
I don't know who he is, and I have no idea what he said to you.
Well, let me bring you up to speed. The package was light by 4 mil. You boys kept the diamonds, which found their way into your team's retirement account. The bad news for you is we can prove it. The good news for you is we don't care. We're here for you.
For us?
For you, Sergeant Brown. Do you know the average retirement age for an operator in the unit?
I'm told it's 39, but some max out around 50.
Well, Sergeant Blaine has lasted longer than most. Where do you think he'll be next year?
In the field with his team.
Your loyalty is admirable, but he's past his prime and he's a security risk.
You're a security risk, pal. You and the Yaleys. You and your pals with the bow ties. Sitting on your asses, attacking the men who defend this country instead of those who want to destroy it.
You misunderstand.
What is it that you want?
It's not what we want, but what we can offer. And I'm offering you another opportunity to serve your country.
I've got one, as we speak, and it's working out just fine.
CIA could use a man inside the unit.
Forget it.
A smart man prepares for the future.
Is that what a smart man does?
You can't jump out of airplanes forever.
I think I got a few years left.
I think you do, too. And that's why I'm asking during those years for you to look ahead. I believe this is called foresight. When an operator outlives his usefulness, we find in him time and time again the same signs. First, he underestimates the danger. Second, he goes soft.
I don't know what that means.
It means he becomes sentimental, becomes less aggressive.
All right. I understand your theoretical position.
What would you say if I told you we see these characteristics in Jonas?
I'd say get your eyes checked.
And if I told you you'll begin to see them yourself?
I'd say you're dead wrong.
And if I could guarantee it?
Am I free to go? Or would you like to tell me a story about the ketchup, too?
Ketchup, or katsia, originated in China as a pickled fish sauce called katsia. The ideogram K. Meaning deep. It can also mean commitment. It's a wonderful language.
I'm going to suppose that we're finished.
We can charge your team with the theft of the diamonds at any time with severe consequences.
Then why haven't you?
To allow this conversation to take place. I believe this is called cover. It's in your best interest and Jonas's to keep this meeting between you and me.
Mm-hmm.
CIA will contact you again. Remember the words Baltic Amber.
Baltic Amber?
When you hear them, you'll be faced with a choice.
And what choice would that be?
Between serving your team leader and serving your country.
Club owner, American expat. Booze, women, drugs.
Give them what they want.
Mm-hmm.
Which one is he?
Right
back again.
Look, seen him before?
Looks like my great uncle. You work with a guy?
I went around with him.
And?
He's been out after dark. He's got loyalty issues.
Not in it for the pure love of the game.
No, he's in it for the money. Plays for the team with the best offer.
Agency sent him our way?
CIA wouldn't touch him. Not with his morals.
What's your pleasure, old timer?
A bit of scotch.
Roll you for it?
Not much of a gambler.
What's your friend do for fun? The reason you're here?
He just walked in.
Oh, wait until he stops moving. This man wants to be rescued. He'll cooperate.
Amber.
It was you when you hugged me, hello!
I have no idea what you're talking about, friend.
I had it when I came in here.
Let's move in.
Come on.
Hold on. Local five.
Where's my wallet? Give me my wallet.
Someone tip him off?
I wonder who that could have been.
Give me my wallet.
What do you want to do? Search me?
I'll do more than search you.
Jonas! You're 5 o'clock!
I want my money for the job, and I want to be paid for the damage.
The deal, as you know, was that you get your money when you deliver our man.
I delivered your man on a silver platter.
You put his life in jeopardy and he ran.
How did I put his life in jeopardy?
You took our money to arrange the meet. Then you took money from the FSB to ruin it.
You think I trashed my club on purpose?
You put on this little pantomime to let our target escape.
No. Back it up. How did I let your target escape?
You took the man's wallet, set up a fight.
He must have dropped it. Vodka makes a man clumsy.
I'm the only thing stood between you and the hospital. And that's only because we need your assistance.
My job was to get this fellow here. Your job was to secure the area. You didn't secure the area. You underestimated the threat, and here we are.
You're going to help us find him.
How am I going to do that?
The woman he's with, she one of yours?
The pro, maybe.
She close with Maslin?
Yeah, she's his pick of the litter.
You're going to take us to her.
Hello again. Jonas doesn't know you're CIA.
That's right. A little slow in the uptake.
I'm not the agency type.
You didn't tell Jonas about our meeting.
Just get us to the girl.
Senator, and you already have a meeting with her.
It's more of a casual gathering than a meeting, but I will speak to her about the case.
Well, I can't ask you to do that, because technically I'm no longer your boss.
Well, consider it a gift.
You're amazing.
Thank you for noticing.
Well, I had my suspicion.
What?
Your 200 hours of community service are complete.
Woo!
You're free.
I have learned so much from you working here.
Thank you.
You're most welcome.
What am I going to do without you?
Please, I was a glorified secretary.
Well, that's not exactly what I meant. I have something for you.
Oh, it's not necessary.
Of course not. But it's also a gift. It's a going away present. A thank you for talking to a senator present. Call it whatever you wish.
No. Wilson, what is this? It's too much. This isn't right.
There's an inscription.
Always here. Wilson. I can't possibly accept this.
Put it on.
I can't.
Tell me why not.
Wilson?
Yes, Christine.
You wanted me to look over the Daltrey depositions.
That's right.
They're boxed up in here.
Well, have at it then.
Last day, huh?
Yes, it's my last day.
Good luck then.
Thank you.
have dinner with me?
I don't think so.
Petrino's at 7. Just meet me.
I don't think so.
We have to talk.
I'm married.
Are you? Are you married? Because I don't see a husband. I don't see him. I don't hear him. I've never heard him mentioned. Have dinner with me. We can figure all this out and you can tell me what it means. Have dinner with me.
Your mission's to get Maslin out of the country safely. But Maslin's not the friend to our country, have you believe.
Eyes on the girl.
I don't know
anything.
Where's the man you were at the club with last night? Where is he?
How would I know that?
Because you're his favorite.
He sees many girls.
You're the first among equals.
He's just
the ghost. Going on a trip?
No.
Where are you meeting him?
Not. Give me that!
Bus tickets. Where are you meeting Maslin?
Maslin's not who you think he is.
And who do I think he is?
Whatever you think, he's the other thing.
What's he done?
No, what's he going to do? He has a recording of the Premier's illegal operation.
I thought there were no recordings.
That's what everyone thinks, and we want it to stay that way.
Snake Doc, FSB, 60 seconds out.
What are you doing? I'm not going with you.
I'll take you to him. They won't.
Your boss should have put a bullet in her.
Don't sit here and tell me my man has gone soft.
I didn't, but you just did.
Rob the station.
Here you go, darling. And I absolutely intend to hold hearings in the Senate.
God bless you.
It's a disgrace. Soldiers coming home.
I agree.
Coming home to unsanitary conditions.
Inadequate medical care.
6 months to see a screen.
I think it's criminal.
It may be criminal.
And Walter Reed isn't the only military hospital with a problem.
The only good news is that the doctors in the field are so good that soldiers are surviving wounds they never did before.
That's no excuse for abandoning them when they come home in pieces.
We need to bring the same medical care and dedication that our men get out there on the battlefield back home to the VA hospitals. Now, some of your husbands saved my life. I will not abandon them or their fellow soldiers. Now, here's what I'd like for
you. I'm afraid this concludes the recreation portion of your visit, Madam Senator.
Already?
We have the business.
Yes, yes. Well, Charlotte, thank you so much for your hospitality. And you really must try to prevent your husband from being so accident prone.
It's a constant chore. It's so good to see you again, Elizabeth. Ladies, thank you so much for being so hospitable to the senator, and particularly thank you for the magnificent desserts, Molly.
Better across your lips than mine.
We're all in your debt. I'll see you on the 14th.
You're coming up to Washington.
I'll give you a call.
Yeah.
Senator, can I have just one brief moment of your time, please?
There's a schedule, Mrs. Gerhardt.
Just one moment, Colonel.
All right.
It's been a while. When are you going to start speaking to her?
She's the one not speaking to me.
How have you been, Tiffany?
Well enough, thank you, ma'am.
And how's your husband?
I'm not sure. He's been deployed for over 2 months. I'm not sure where.
How have you been spending your time?
Well, there's the kids, of course, though now they're at summer camp. And I've been volunteering at a law firm. My boss, Wilson James, he represents a client, which is what I wanted to discuss with you. The client, he's about to lose his home over, I promise you, a misunderstanding.
All right, go on.
We've been trying to schedule a meeting with someone at the Department of the Interior to clear up this legal mess, but no one seems interested.
You all right, Elizabeth? Tiffany needs me to make a phone call.
Oh, you're gonna do it?
Yes. What's your client's name?
Right around the corner. Here. Learn your new name.
I didn't think anyone was coming for me.
Shows you how wrong a man can be. Let's get you out of here. Open here. Документы. Добро. Вы? Чей?
I don't have them.
Нема документов.
Get to the car, get him out of here. Калиаска. Якай няни засануться. Якай няни мене папакагунц. Як я могу. Пора рызначатся. Без моих и сабов.
Упустите далее. Проверка документов. Пойдемте. Идите за нами.
Ну и сколько там будет?
Where's the recording?
On the memory card.
Where? Forget the recording. I'm going back for Jonas.
Going back?
This is your mission.
I need to get out of this country before they kill me.
Look, we rendezvous with my man once he finds his papers.
They're not
he's
gonna
find his papers. He thinks he's invulnerable, so he let his guard down. I'm not leaving my man behind because you stole his papers.
What's going on here?
I told you. Didn't I tell you? Where's the memory card?
Awaiting pickup.
Pickup by whom? Syrians?
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't know you were coming. I have to sell it. I needed money to get out.
We can't let this information go to Damascus. All right, when is the pickup?
Soon.
Where?
An hour from here.
If we go back for your man now, we sacrifice the mission. What are your objectives, Sergeant Brown? Right now, your country needs your services. So what's it going to be? Your man or your mission?
Hello? Mac, when do
did you get home?
An hour ago. I was going to surprise you, but you weren't home.
Oh, I missed you so much.
I missed you too, baby.
It was a long one.
Now you don't have to tell me. Well, there's pretty and then there's that dress.
Well, it's a law firm dinner for some clients in town tonight.
Don't give anyone a heart attack.
I didn't know you'd be home so soon. I could cancel.
I gotta clear some stuff up at work. I just came to get some clothes.
You cancel your thing, I'll cancel mine.
I have got to put this mission to rest before my head hits the pillow. I'll tell you what. After your thing, we'll catch up, eh? Mm.
Sure.
It's good to be back.
When did we find out?
Senator Webb says soon.
Tiffy, thank you.
Max back home.
When?
Today.
Well, it doesn't change anything.
Doesn't it?
No. Soon he'll be gone again. And then what happens to you?
I range her on.
For a logistics clerk? I know enough about the Army to know that if he really wanted to put down roots and be with you, he could. So why does he keep abandoning you?
It's more complicated than that. He's a good man.
Where's a good man tonight? Home again after 2 months away? Where is he? It's complicated.
Yes.
Well, I know if I were him, I wouldn't let you out of my sight for a minute, much less 2 months.
I'm married. I have 2 children. I have a life that you're asking me to throw away, which may be the very definition of selfishness. I mean, what is this? What is this thing that we have between us, which isn't even real? I mean, what do you expect me to tell my daughters?
That they deserve the best.
The best?
Yes.
What is the best?
Be happy. It has been done before, you know, often with great results. It's why we as a society employ divorce judges for the chance to finally be not selfish, but intelligent enough to be happy.
You're selling a fantasy.
I'm falling in love with you.
Well, stop.
Thus, I have 2 simple questions. How do you feel about your husband? And how do you feel about me?
Hi, I'm Christine Ross. Are you Sergeant Gerhardt?
Yeah, that's me.
I work with your wife. It was her last day at the office, and she left some personal items behind. I didn't want the cleaning crew taking off with it. Is she around?
No, she's not, but thank you.
You're welcome.
Nice of you to bring the stuff by.
Oh, we're all very fond of her down at the office.
That's where she is tonight.
At the office?
She is at a firm dinner.
Firm dinner?
With clients.
I didn't hear about it, but then I'm sort of at the bottom of the ladder. We're gonna miss her down there.
I'm sure you will.
Wilson really started to lean on her for a lot of things.
Well, you know, the girls and I are pretty happy to have her back home full time.
Sorry for bothering you.
Not at all. Thank you for bringing that stuff over.
Sure. Bye.
See ya.
Thank you.
they laid rose petals on the ground for the princess to more comfortably walk.
What?
Fairy tale my aunt used to tell me.
You're drinking.
Well, I wasn't gonna have this last one, but he wanted a road trip with his buddies.
You're drunk.
Is that a medical diagnosis or merely a lay opinion?
Did something happen on the mission?
The what?
The mission. You were gone a long time. Did something happen?
Ryan gave me his orders. I carried him out.
Now, I know you can't be specific. God forbid they let you talk to your wife.
Well, then let's just blame everything on the job.
Is there something else?
That's as good an excuse as any. I'm good going with that.
Reentry's always hard.
Is that a fact?
And this was a longer deployment than usual.
Well, then it's just a reentry thing.
If you're not happy, then tell me why. Is it me? Is it the kids? Are you happy?
Right now, I'm just going for numb.
Please don't.
You'd like numb better than the alternative.
Show me.
Two hours to the left.
Go.
As you wish.
Come on, lady. Sorry, it's my fault.
Maybe
you can help me. I'm looking at my map. Okay, do you know if this is north or is this... Thank you, I'll figure it out.
To Senator Webb this morning, and she's got your client in meeting with the number two at Interior next week.
Oh, that's wonderful. My boss will be so thrilled.
Helps to have friends in high places.
Do you and the senator go back a long way?
We go back to the old neighborhood. What do you need?
I'd like you to speak to your husband on my behalf.
About what?
About Mac. You told me once if there was anything you could do. Well, now there is. There's something you can do.
All right.
Mac came home from a mission. A long one. And he came home...
Yes?
He came home changed. But if I were to go to your husband, the colonel...
And register a concern, say your husband has changed, then it's official.
Yes.
Psych evaluations, a meddlesome wife, and the end of Mac's career.
Yes, that's right.
So instead?
Instead, could you express a general concern from your own recent observations? Ask your husband to talk to Mac and get Mac to talk to someone else.
He won't talk to you.
No.
I see. I'm so happy to be able to do something for you to begin to pay you back. Very happy.
took you?
Got held up. How'd you get back?
Hook and crook.
Yeah, Lesser Man might have underestimated you.
Congratulations. Give me the money.
We don't need him.
No. Stay with us until we cross the border.
Jonas, we don't need him anymore.
No. We cut him loose right now. Give him a chance to make a profit. FSB would surely love to know where we're headed.
Give me my money.
In time. I'll make arrangements with our gallant allies across the border. Get Maslin in the air. Don't need confirmation that you're alive. Come with me.
We need your help with another task.
Me and my team are wrapping up.
How much do you know about your team leader? There are more than pilfered diamonds in this district.
Take a look at Jonas's Christmas past.
Just a bunch of paper.
You've known Jonas, what, 2 years? We've been tracking him for 20. We're on the same team, and the mission has changed. You can't let Maslin leave the country. You need to kill him now.
You're out of your mind.
He's planning to sell the secrets on that ship to enemies of the United States. He set a meeting with officials in Syria. That information gets out means a new tribal war, the deployment of thousands of American soldiers, perhaps men you've served with. You don't want their blood on your conscience.
You want Maslin dead, you kill him. I won't betray my team leader.
Your team leader has outlived his usefulness as a member of the unit.
Well, he beat us back here.
He got back here because we need him here. The CIA diverted the FSB to get him back here safely.
Maybe that's the truth. Or maybe that's a convenient lie told after the fact.
3 months ago, I said you'd have a choice between saving your friend and saving the country.
And how does Jonas fit into the equation?
You're going to kill Maslin, and Jonas is going to take the fall.
Morning for shooting.
God ever invent a bad one?
Not as of this interchange. Nice work on that mission. Some ugly business down there.
No worse than the usual.
Well, it's the usual that worries me. What do you do to see the doc?
Head doc or the physical?
Head doc.
Couple months.
What do you think about running in there a little early?
You got a problem with my performance, Colonel?
Not at all, son. It's possible that we put more on your shoulders as of late than is your share. Maybe it's time for a break.
Don't need one.
You qualified to make that call?
Who better than me?
That's the question.
I'm dealing with a couple things.
All right.
But I'm 5x5 mission ready.
You sure?
Absolutely.
Good, because you're doing a hell of a job out there, Mac. Back at it.
To the parking lot. Are you planning on coming into the office?
I came here to tell you that I can't do this.
Tell me you're happy with him.
This isn't the solution.
Then why does it feel the way it feels?
It's it's only temporary.
Doesn't have to be.
I've gone down this road before. And I got hurt.
I would never hurt you.
A lot of other people got hurt. And I won't do that to you.
I'll take my chances.
Can't take chances you don't even know about.
What are you talking about?
What I'm saying is this can't happen. And I'm sorry, but it can't happen.
Wait here.
What about me?
You?
I got you here. Deal's a deal.
Find your own way home.
I can indeed.
You took my papers.
You've just taken mine.
Always carry around blank paper?
Never know when you're going to want to write something down.
How far is the border from here?
About 2 kilometers.
Show me. Put him in the truck for safe passage. FSB will have his picture up at every checkpoint by now.
Come on.
Are you sure your partner knows what he's doing?
That's right.
I don't know.
Is there another option that I don't know about?
No.
Okay, well, that's number one. Number two, if any man in the world can keep you safe, it's him.
Mm-hmm. Why in there?
FSB is looking for it. It's the safest way to get you to the other side. Look, we got a couple of minutes. Why don't you stretch your legs and have a smoke, huh?
Thank you.
Jonas, stay down.
The hell happened?
Sniper took Maslin out.
Where?
Up there, I think.
All right, local cops will be here soon. In the car on the 3 count. 1, 2, 3.
Take a stroll.
A stroll?
He wanted a smoke.
Did I order you to let the man walk around in the open?
You did not. Don't make the call.
Now's the time to call the colonel and let him know that the man that we were assigned to protect is lying dead in the street.
It was my mistake, so I'll take the blame.
It doesn't work that way.
Well, the error was mine.
Mission goes sour, I answer for it. Didn't you learn that rule?
Have a drink. Why me?
Beg your pardon?
Why'd you pick me?
Because you're a great operator, because you have 3 degrees and speak 4 languages, because you have a proven ability for discretion. And today you did your country a great service.
At what cost?
Well. The company will call on you again.
I'm sorry, I'm not your man.
You want to know why we picked you, Bob? Here's the truth. We didn't. All we did was make you an offer. You picked us.
Drinks are on me. What are you and your bicycle bud sipping over there? Strawberry daiquiris?
You want something?
No, man. Look, I'm sorry. Here's 200 bucks as a sign of my contrition. Make it 500.
All right. Two pitchers.
See, no, for your troubles. I'm getting divorced. My wife found someone new, so. Here's what I did this morning. Cleaned out the savings account, the checking account, the whole deal. $35,000 total, cash. All mine, the whole nest egg, and I'm gonna blow it all before she wakes up next to this new guy who figures out what hit her.
Probably not the best place to be flashing your cash around, man.
Hey, you can't make friends. Buy them.
All right. Of course you'll take the offer. It's the right move.
How are you going to answer for today?
I've had to answer for worse.
Why should I work for CIA?
For exactly the reasons they told you. Can't jump out of planes forever.
You seem to?
No. Anno Domini catches us all. But you're reluctant.
Well, if I take their offer, the CIA will have a man in the unit.
No. It means the unit has a man in the CIA.
You know, the spooks, they didn't play it very smart.
No?
No. They tried to turn me against you using trumped up allegations and fake documents.
Makes you think they're fake.
Here I come,
spend it unwisely.
Give us the rest of that money.
You know, buddy, it's gonna take more than a knife to get my life savings.
This do the trick?
Whoa. Whoa, whoa, whoa. All right, look, as long as the bitch back home doesn't get a dime of it, you can have it, all right? I've been needing this. Thank you. And good night.